Alright, so hierarchy of laws in India, why do we need to understand this particular concept? Because one law cannot override another law, rules cannot override act, rules cannot override constitution, nothing in this world can override our constitution. Please understand, constitution is a supreme document. Government, parliament, state government, none of the authority, ICI, municipal corporation, none of the authority can make anything which is beyond constitution. If they brought any law or any rule or any provision which is beyond constitution, the moment it is launched, we will declare it as ultra vires. Ultra vires?
Yes.
Beyond the power. Okay. And anything which is beyond the power is void ab initio. It's invalid. It's invalid from the beginning. You understand? And something which is invalid from the beginning cannot be followed. Okay. Hello. And please understand how this particular things operates in India. Hierarchies of law, the supreme law or the utmost law. You understand? Apex law of India is Constitution of India. Constitution of India is divided into three parts. Preamble, that is introduction to Constitution. Then there are 448 articles. Like we are having chapters in our book, you must have seen, you must have read any book or any act. There are different chapters. Likewise, we are having articles in Constitution. 448 articles. Whatever is happening in India today, legally, everything is written in my Constitution. You understand? Whole procedure, how to run a nation, everything is written in that particular articles. To support articles, we are having schedules. Okay? Because some points which has to be extended one, so extended point they had not written in articles, for that they are referring to schedules. Alright? Now, Constitution of India was prepared by Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar and is the committee. He was the chairperson of the committee. There were many people, many scholars involved into the process. They had taken more than 2.5 years to draft this particular legislation, Constitution of India, after independence. And that's why we had got independence in 1947, but we became actual republic states in 1949. So they had taken this much time. Expert of this particular nation has taken this much time to draft a document, and that document is Constitution of India. Am I clear? It is one of the most important document. Majority provision of Constitution of India had been taught to us when we were in school. Okay? Bharatiya Samvidhan. Alright, it was there for 10 marks, 25 marks, I don't know, whatever marks were allocated, but they had taught us Constitution of India during the time when we were not able to understand the act. Okay, what is the relevance of this particular law? What is the significance of this particular law in the industry? And right now also, they don't want that people of India should become literate or educated so far as Constitution is concerned. Because if you understand, then you will understand the politics. Alright, you don't know how to become Prime Minister, you don't know how to become a President, you don't know how to become Supreme Court Judge. You don't know the process, you don't know how to become Governor. Why don't know the process? It was there in your syllabus. Which standard? 7th standard, 8th standard. That time if somebody asks you, beta, what you want to become? Pilot. You know, police. So this is what you used to say. Nobody has said, I want to become President. I wanted to become Prime Minister. I wanted to become Governor of India. Nobody had said this. Actually, we should have said this and we should have followed that particular path. Then they will come when you would have become. But they had taught you all these provisions when you were very young. You know, you used to buy out only 2 or 3 points. To Bharatacha Nagrik Asava. Ha, he should be, citizen of India. Second, he should complete his age of 21, you understand, not 18, 21. Now majority of this batch is eligible according to that particular clause, isn't it? Yes. Every one of you is a citizen of India. Majority of you had completed 21 years. Then can you become President of India? No, because along with these two criteria, there are a lot of other criteria that you don't know. Because nobody had taught you that. Hello. That is a failure of system. That is not failure of you and me. That is a failure of system. I believe that Constitution should have become one of the expert course after the graduation. That if you wanted to go further into the system, this is the course, this is the degree which is dedicated for Constitution of India. Okay? We should have courses in India which teach Quran, which teach Bible, which teach Gita as a study material. people, internationally people are doing research on this document, whereas you and me haven't gone through it. Okay, and one of the judicial Gita is part this Constitution of India. We are Indian citizen and we are like, you know, topmost qualified people, isn't it? But still we don't study it. If we don't study it, can we expect it from graduates or people who are going into school that they will read this and they will understand it? Can we expect that politicians who are sitting in parliament, they had read it? Never. Few exceptions are there. And that's why they are exceptional people, because they had read this particular document. This document gives immense power. Now what I wanted to say about this particular document is here is that the document was prepared in 1949. Obviously Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar and his committee had never imagined that in 2017 government of India will bring GST. Did they imagine? No. Obviously it was not written in my constitution. And anything which is not written in my constitution, if government brings that in India, it will be invalid. That's what I'm trying to teach you. Alright? So what they had done, what government has done before launching GST in India, they had ratified my constitution. Okay? We people call it amended. We don't amend constitution, we provide ratification to the constitution. There is a whole process behind it. Radhika is the right person, you talk to her. How do they change constitution? Okay, there is a whole process and they had ratified. So whatever constitution we are following today is not constitution given by them in 1949. We are following the amended version or ratified version. Who is ratifying it? Central government, obviously with a majority approval from state governments. Okay, so there is a whole process into it. Sir, as per constitution of India, they make act. So first they made act, GST act, or first they change constitution? Tell me. First they should change constitution, first they may act. Because to make act, you need to derive a power. And that power will be written in constitution. So in 2016, please understand, in 2016 they changed my Indian constitution. And after that they drafted GST law. And that's why GST was in news from 2016 onwards itself. Because the moment they changed the constitution, which was one of the difficult tasks. Because BJP is not having majority in all states. Some states are under different, you know, different political party, and they may not give approval to change constitution. And if you can't allow to change constitution, you cannot bring any law in India. And that's why in 2016 they first changed constitution, and in 2017 they brought GST in India. Alright? Yeah? So under constitution we make act. Acts are divided into chapters, chapters are divided into sections, sections are divided into subsection, subsections are divided into clauses, clauses are divided into sub-clauses. At least this much you should know. Alright? So act will be divided into chapters, chapters will be divided into sections, sections will be further divided into subsections, subsection will further divided into clauses, clauses will be divided into sub-clauses. Alright? So sometime we read sub-clause of clause and then subsection of section and then act. And sometimes we refer chapter also. So in income tax we refer chapter 6A. Yes. Alright. In section 56 subsection 2 clause 10. We had read it like that. Clause 10 of subsection 2 of section 56 of income tax act 1961. You understand it? You understand? Sometime I will refer provisions of direct tax because that is done. So some logics I can derive from, I can borrow from direct tax as well. Alright. So acts will be divided into chapters and section. Who makes act in India? Some people say Supreme Court. Some people say government. Both answers are wrong. Okay? Everyone has responsibility. Who is responsible to make law? Parliament. Parliament means two houses. Lower house, upper house. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Okay? These two houses makes law for whole nation. Whole nation. When it comes to state level, now there are certain acts which are applicable only in Maharashtra. There are certain acts which are applicable only in Gujarat. There are certain level of act which are applicable only in Kerala. So to manage that particular judicial boundary, okay, they have their own state legislative assembly. Now you need to understand this 2-3 words first of all. Legislative assembly means legislature. They are legislature. Sir, who is the legislature? Legislature is a person or authority who makes legislation. Okay? Legislation means law. Okay? Legislations are prepared by legislatures. Okay? Who are the legislatures at national level? Parliament. So, national level law will be made by Parliament. But I have not written state legislative assembly here. Why? Very basic reason I told you, I am not teaching you at state level, I am teaching you at National level. And that's why we refer only national laws. National laws are made by parliament. State laws are made by state legislature, assembly. I'll give you some reference. We are in Churchgate, we are having Vidhan Sabha. You can go and check. That Vidhan Sabha is making law for Maharashtra. Okay. You go to Delhi, you go and see Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, Parliament, House of Parliament. That building is making law for whole India. We are having channels also, TV channels also, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha channel. You can go and check that particular channel. There they make law. That is the house where they make law. Am I clear? Yeah. So far as Kerala is concerned, there is a place, Trivandrum or Thiruvananthapuram. Alright. There they are having Niyama Sabha. Like we are having Vidhan Sabha, they are having Niyama Sabha. In Bangalore, you go, you will find Vidhana Sauda or Niyama Sauda. We call Sabha in Bangalore, like in Kannada, they call it Sauda. Alright. Whatever it is, every state government will have this kind of buildings there. Okay. Which will make law only for Karnataka, which will make law only for Maharashtra, only for Kerala. You understand? That I cannot write here. So state level laws are made by state legislative assembly and state central level laws are made by parliament. I have written only parliament. I'm going to ask you one basic question. I do expect answer from you guys. Can parliament tomorrow makes any law which will override constitution? Parliament is the authority who makes law. Can parliament makes a law which will override constitution? No. That's why on second level act come. First level is constitution of India. Sir, you witnessed this particular thing in any new legislation that they had brought from 2013 onwards. Okay. Companies Act 2013, RERA Act, okay, Real Estate Regulation Act, or you can see even GST Act. Majority content is written in rules. When I taught you Income Tax Act, I had hardly referred any rules. Very few rules I had referred. Otherwise, everything is written in sections. Everything is written in sections. Now, it very like very few content was written in rules. But when I teach you GST law, I will tell you and I will show you that majority content are written in rules, not in sections. Okay. Obviously, sections are there. Sections are also there. But the content, majority for the content that we follow, okay, the GST that we follow in real world, practical world, those provisions are not written in sections. They are written in rules. Okay. And government is very smart for that. When you read section, they say registration process will be followed as prescribed. What word they put in law? As prescribed. And the moment you see this particular word as prescribed, so in section they don't have prescribed anything. You don't know how to register person, you don't know how to pay tax, you don't know how to file GST return, because everywhere they had written in section this you need to file GST return. Procedure as may be prescribed, form as may be prescribed, fees as may be prescribed. The moment you see this particular word prescribed in any law, not only in my taxation law, any law, prescribed means there will be rules. There will be rules. And who makes rules? Rules are made by central government. A central level, central government, state level? That you should understand. Sir, is there any difference between parliament and central government? Obviously, yes. You need to understand political structure for that. Okay. Government means BJP. You understand? Government, governing body as of now. And parliament means combination of all parties, all political parties, their representatives are sitting in parliament. All state representatives are sitting in parliament. Okay. Yeah. And that's why to make law, we need approval from everyone. Okay. But to implement law, government does not have to take approval from everyone. When they make rule, they put it on table of parliament. People have to read it. If in 30 days if somebody objected, then only they will change the rule. Otherwise, the rule will come into effect automatically. So far as sections are concerned, is it very easy to change sections in India? Is it very easy to change law in India, amend law in India? No, because it requires parliamentary approval. And you know how good they behave in parliament. Yeah, they don't behave like a human. They behave like something else. Like right now also somewhere in like some assembly, somebody was beating somebody else. Literally, they were beating each other. Alright, because of Patil Bihari Vajpayee, again, somewhere in Maharashtra only, somewhere it happened. Like one person, like they opposed for this, party, they representative opposed for the this Patil Bihari Vajpayee's, you know, Shraddhanjali process was conducted. And they started beating that guy. And that is the House of Parliament. Like, not like government house, like this is legislative house. Okay, it's a pure house, and there also they are behaving like that. You know, Rahul Gandhi is there. So you people, for sometime when you get bored, You people go and watch stand-up comedian. Huh? You watch stand-up comedies, okay? And one of the suggestions that YouTube will give you is videos of Rahul Gandhi. Automatically suggested. And people are watching it also. As if it is a stand-up comedy videos. It's not stand-up comedy, it's a House of Parliament. Hello. So, amending law is not easy because of parliamentary approach. But amending, changing rules is very easy in India. And that's why they are very smart. They are very smart. They are not the core of law, the actual implementation of law, they are putting in rules. Okay? So that tomorrow if they wanted to change it, they can change. Government can change it. Now, who is government? That depends on you, people. Hello. Who should be your government? That power is given to you. So power is in our hand. Now, whether to exercise that power or not, that again depends to you. Alright? Sir, for whole world, they study only this much. We professional, we study one more document. Oh, or few more documents. They are bylaws. Bylaws means laws made by you people. For you. Okay? So, this society is there. Satellite Park Society is there. This society where we are taking lectures. Alright? They are not allowing outsider to pass through the society. This is the law. Who made this law? Central government? State government? Municipal Corporation of Mumbai? No, the society itself made the law. Society also have one governing body. Committee, secretary, you know, chairperson is there. All these things are there. So, that is happening according to bylaws of this particular cooperative housing society. Hello. Yeah. So, we are also going to become member of one particular union. Okay. When you become chartered accountant, there is no difference between you and me. Okay, when you become a company secretary, there will not be any difference between company secretary and others. Please understand, we are going to become member of this particular institute. Okay, it is AOP, body of individuals. Some people coming together for common object in India. So, we have to follow our own laws. We are also having laws. Now, that is not in act. Okay, if I ask you what is the valuation of inventory here, they will say cost price or NRV, whichever is lower. If I ask last mincher, they will also say cost price or NRV, whichever is lower. I had asked the same question in Kerala. They also said cost price or NRV is lower. If you go to Delhi and ask in North India, any part in North India, what is the valuation principle of inventory? Cost price or NRV, which is lower. Why the hell everybody is giving right answer or same answer? Because it is written in accounting standard 2. Sir, why are we following accounting standard 2? Is it act? No. It just your parent is teaching you better how to do accounting. So you are cooking, your mother will tell you better put this or don't put this. This is too much and this is like not sufficient. You understand? Yeah. So who is our mother when we talk about this? ICI. Okay. Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. What they had given us? Accounting standard. That's why every member has to follow accounting standards. Not only that, we are auditors also. So standards on auditing are also given by ICI. Are we under obligation to follow the standards? Or is it optional? Why? Because you are a member and as a member you need to follow this. If you want to change it, you are having that power also. If you don't want to follow this, if something wrong is there, you are having power to write letter to ICA and make amendment in accounting standards as well. Okay? We are bringing international standards at India level now. Indias are there, which is, you know, equivalent to IFRS. So my audit has already gone to international level. My account is going to international level. My GST law, indirect taxes had already reached to international level. Income tax laws are also like in compliance with international law and they are about to change the law. Whole act will be replaced as the direct tax code. Then it will be also international level law. So we are going global. Mera desh badal raha hai. Right? And because mera desh badal raha hai, obviously there will be change in judicial system of the India as well. Alright? Sir, guidance note are again, you know, the extension of GN is guidance note. You can understand, this is not law. This is not section. It's just a guidance note. Please understand, ICA follow this. ICA will issue guidance tomorrow. Your institute will follow guidance note tomorrow. What is CAS, sir? Cost accounting standard. How to do material costing, how to do process costing. You know, what is batch costing? This is given to cost account. This is given by cost accounting standard. No matter whether you are doing CA, CS or CMA, you need to understand what is cost accounting standard and that's why costing is there in everyone's syllabus. Whatever costing you are doing as per cost accounting standards. Okay? Company secretary people, tomorrow you have to follow compliance standard. CS stands for compliance. You people are CS, company secretaries, follows compliance standard. Who will issue compliance standard? ICSI. So we have to see, our institutes are mothers. we are children, all right? Our institutes will teach us what to do and how to do, okay? Those standards are known as bylaws. Tomorrow there is something wrong in GST Act. You know, when you read Act over the period of time, you can realize, okay, this provision is wrong. Like I taught you the definition of relative in income tax. Her children and my children. So my children is also my relative. Her children is also my relative. That is wrong in law. Can tomorrow Institute of Chartered Accountant put this particular observation and say, beta, this section is wrong and we follow definition like this? Do we have power to do that? Can we override rule? Can we override act? Can we override constitution? No. And that's why this is the hierarchy. The supreme power is constitution, then act, and then rule. Rules cannot override act. Act cannot override constitution. And therefore, rules can never override constitution. Any rule which is not in line with constitution of India will be declared void ab initio immediately. Please understand. It's ultra vires. Okay? Yeah? Please write it down.